Today, we are confronted not with a breakdown of our agriculture, but with a breakdown of our imagination and our leadership. What we need today is the concern and the determination that wrought the great agricultural revolution of the 1930s. So much then for our program. This is what I proposed at Newton in 1956, and this is what we will do in Washington. I'm not ashamed of what I said at Cassin 4 years ago, and I will not be ashamed of what I have said here at Newton today. Now, there is something more that I must speak to you about. Something more that I think we can do right now. Something that I have done time and again, and will do every chance that I get. And I mean by that explaining the farmers' problems to the rest of the country. This, I think, is one of the farmers' greatest needs. Politicians tell him all too often what he wants to hear about his troubles and their remedies. But all too seldom are his troubles explained to other people, to the city people. As I've traveled around the state in farm prosperity, I want to say to the American people that the farmer just isn't getting a fair share of our national prosperity. Now, many people, and you might as well face it, don't understand the uncertainties of farming and the necessity for farm stability. They never stop to think that a farmer doesn't know what price he will get when he plants a crop, or when he harvests it, or even when he loads it on the wagon to take it to town. General Motors has built in price support. Suppose General Motors' production depended on the weather. Suppose it had to sell all of its automobiles in a matter of 3 weeks. Suppose it didn't have the capital to hold its products off the market. It would need protection too. And from this present administration, I think it would get it. There are